successful. One of the, just in this last week, there was a newspaper article about a hearing that's going to come up in Wednesday, and I'll mention that in a moment. But what the newspaper article said was that Bill Risner is going to court and trying to get it. There's a real confusion between the role of the lawyer and the client. It's the Democratic Party that has been working hard to get this data. At every stage and every time we're in court, all of the votes, every vote from our executive committee has been unanimous. And it has been the unanimous support of the party that has enabled us to take strong positions and proceed in court. And the issues could not be more fundamental. It is a fact that these computers are easy to cheat with. That's a fact. They have been built with virtually none of the security that you would see in any other computer program. And the simple fact is they've been built to facilitate cheating. That's a fact. And we have in Pima County the default system, and in a way we probably prefer to keep having that at the moment because we have some of the software where we're able to look at the database, and the system in Phoenix that they use is really worse than the system that we have here. We have a set of laws in Arizona that says that if one is going to challenge an election, you need to do it in 5 days with specificity. It's absolutely impossible to do that. We received a sworn affidavit from a local citizen saying that he was told by the computer operator in Pima County that he had rigged an election. Our analysis of the database is consistent with there being violations of the usual norms, the usual way it handles, and it looks like that indeed may be the case. We don't know, but it looks like that indeed may be the case. The RTE election, which is the election that I'm talking about, is one that this party supported and endorsed. But we're concerned about an election department that has the capacity and individuals that may not be honestly counting ballots. Our county treasurer and Arizona law says that the county treasurer is the person that keeps ballots, and after a period of time she's required to destroy the ballots. So Beth Ford, the county treasurer, has gone to court and asked the judge whether she can destroy the ballots for the RT election without ever having them examined. The county and Beth Ford's lawyer has filed a motion that will be heard this Wednesday at 10 o'clock before Judge Harrington in the Superior Court, and it's on a jurisdictional question. And what they're saying is that if you assume as a fact that the election was rigged and those ballots would show that an election was rigged, that the court cannot look at the ballots, that there can be no examination by anyone because you only have 5 days to examine any election, and therefore the court has no jurisdiction. The result of that, of course, would be that any election could be rigged and the persons that do it could continually do it without any examination. Now, our party is not challenging the election. What we're concerned about in the focus of that hearing is we want to know if our elections have been rigged. We want to know if that election has been honest, because the same person's there and the same election director of Pima County, we know has lied to our political party about what's gone on and has not been straight with us. So if in fact the court has no jurisdiction, that means that no one can check. The only person that could check would be the Attorney General, and that's a discretionary matter, and so far he's chosen not to exercise any discretion in that regard. So we're dealing with an issue that is of importance to this party. We're dealing with an issue that is absolutely fundamental for our democracy, which is if you're gonna use computers, we need to be able to have an ability to check and make sure that the votes are honestly counted. And the work that's been done by our election integrity group has been tremendous. I'm not sure there's anything like it in the United States. There's probably no one in the United States like John Brady. Project that we're involved with. I think everyone can take some pride in the strength of this party and pushing that project, because it is fundamental. It's what we're all working for. It's not an honest count. We don't have much of anything. And I invite anyone who has the time, the hearing's at 10 o'clock Wednesday with Judge Harrington. This is a